one for all the beans in the Philippines. It's Martin Nguyen and Kevin Belingon, the world interim bantamweight title. They'll test each other out early. They'll see what each other has to offer. There's tremendous respect between the two, but both said they would finish each other. Nguyen said he'd choke out Belingon. Belingon said, I'll knock him out any round I want to. Both of them carry tremendous power, particularly in their hands.
Martin knows they're very well matched in the striking area, but he believes he's gonna have a wrestling advantage, and he wants to show that wrestling in the second, third rounds. So expect him to kind of dance with Kevin and see what Kevin has to offer on the feet, because we've seen this swagger come out of Martin Nguyen where he drops his hands, consistently drifting from left to right, and also changing stances.
That right hand of Belingon is cocked and ready. Martin testing the distance, flicks out a jab, outside leg kick, second one of the bout so far from Belingon. Fake again there from Nguyen. Shoots in, and a bit of a head clash on the way in there. Belingon just checking for any damage. There will be a moment to perhaps have the ringside position take a look at Belingon, or maybe just Olivia Cost.
That mullet acts like a pretty good helmet too, Michael. You can see the clash of heads right there as Martin came in. He ducked underneath. Kevin saw it coming in as he threw the right hand, but had the arms in the right spot, ready to defend the takedown. But as Martin came up, he threw a nice little right hand.
Now, entry tell rules and athlete is allowed 5 minutes for recovery and examination. If they're unable to continue, an official decision will be given, but we're okay to go on here. Big tension inside the Mall of Asia Arena. Will we see another Filipino world champion? Or will Martin Nguyen become a historic three-division champion?
Martin's diving down. He's not really changing levels. He's just bending over, trying to go for that double leg. Really got to change levels with your legs. You got to lower your level down to get that takedown effectively.
Belingon like a ticking time bomb, like a hand grenade. Once he pulls the pin, he explodes on his opponent. Will he pull the pin here in the first round? Controlling center cage, looks for the outside leg, does Martin Nguyen.
Martin continues to chase takedowns like that. Look for Kevin to time a knee.
Look for Martin to time that devastating right hand. Belingon edges forward, resets now. The man with the mighty mullet. Nguyen dancing, inviting. Outside crescent kick there from Belingon.
Sidestep.
Left hook from Belingon, the silencer with the outside leg kick.
Did you see that wild right hand they threw as they exited? Kevin Belingon does that so beautifully. Right as they're exiting the exchange or the clinch, he unleashes a huge right or left hand.
Fakes the hook off the lead hand as Belingon fakes the right cross as Martin Nguyen. Careful not to shoot in sloppily on Belingon.
Looks like I had my timing wrong with the second, third round. Nguyen immediately going after the wrestling. But he's kind of diving in with his head down, not really changing levels properly on the double leg. So kind of going after like a rugby tackle almost on his takedowns.
Trying to push him back from center cage. Thought about the right hand. Front kick there from Nguyen. More of a punt kick though. Had some stuff chance go up again for Kevin Belingon. Thought about the Wushu sidekick. End of the first round, we go to the town. It's one championship, Reign of Guilt, live from Manila in the Philippines.
Look at this, Kevin headhunting, going up top. Look at this, watch the exchange. Immediately, as soon as they exit the clinch, Kevin swings wildly. He's got to be careful on leaving his head up like that, but also Martin's got to be careful not to get caught on something on the way out.
I want that king down the middle. And get ready to drop the lid.
And there is Martin Nguyen's wife, Brooke. Great to have her here at Cape Side, supporting her husband as always. And there's Master Fari Soliowski, head coach of Team KMA out of Sydney.
Man, Michael, I've never had a family member compete. I've always had friends, teammates, really close compadres competing in the cage. I can't imagine what it's like to have the father of your children inside the cage competing with everything he's got.
Second round, set for five. It's a sellout inside the Mall of Asia Arena. It's the main event for the interim bantamweight world title. Australia and Vietnam versus the Philippines. Martin Nguyen and Kevin Belingon. Nguyen up on the balls of his feet. Switching stance here.
Kevin has slightly adjusted his stance. His left hand is a little bit higher and a little bit extended normally, so maybe it's to counter that right hand of Martin Nguyen. You can see the nice wide stance of Kevin, which usually sets up that front push kick, and also it sets up the spin.
There's that punt kick again, and a whipping head kick from Martin Nguyen. Side kick to the knee, fell short for Kevin Belingon.
Martin sidesteps very well, especially when he sidesteps. He's sidestepping to the power side of Belingon. So you can see him as he's moving away. If Kevin can time it right, he could throw that right hand and catch Martin as he's coming around to the power side.
Let's see if Nguyen can find range with the cranium cracker, the headache maker, the overhand right. There's that Wushu sidekick from Belingon. A powerful Filipino in the red trunks. Fake there from Nguyen. In and out from Martin Nguyen. Haven't seen Belingon pull the pin yet. Evades a little rush. Drop down levels momentarily. Fakes level change again.
Caught Martin on the shuffle. Trying to ollie shuffle, and he caught him with that left hand as he spins right there.
There was the turning back kick to the liver. The one that sent Andrew Leone reeling last time out. Jab from Nguyen at full extension.
Michael, we've seen so many members of Team Lakai put on the performances of a lifetime. Jay Hay back in Macau against Adriel Moraes. We've seen Fulling just get better and better. These guys are putting on shows, and this is Kevin's moment to not only capture his first world title, but really to announce to the world that Team Lakai is for real.
Nguyen's team believes that the further this one went, the more tired Belingon would become and the stronger Martin Nguyen would grow.
Well, Kevin's never seen those championship rounds. And look, he puts everything he has into these shots, and he's missing a lot of these wild hooks. That's going to take energy out of him, especially if we see the fourth and fifth round.
Is there any sense of vengeance here after Martin Nguyen knocked out his teammate Edwards Belaya? That was when Nguyen captured the world title. He's down here at bantamweight tonight.
That's the fifth takedown that Belingon stuffed. Martin's got to put together some combinations before threatening the takedown like that. There's that hammer over right hand.
Telegraph that overhand right. Belingon. Will we see the little man flurry with that incredible power?
See, he could throw that right hand, get Belingon to lift up his hands, and then shoot in for the takedown. Use that weapon as a setup. Get people thinking about it, because you know the entire world knows he wants to throw it. Hide it behind the takedown.
upping the intensity. 70 seconds left in the second round. Another hook from the Filipino. A cutting side kick to the thigh from Belingon.
Martin's a little bit too close in distance for that. You can see how quickly he closes the distance as Martin tries to spin as well. Kevin likes to have a little bit more space between his opponents when he throws that spinning attack.
Nguyen said he wanted to bring the heat, Mitch. Is he bringing the heat here in Manila tonight so far?
I think he's trying to get a read on Kevin, you know? I've sparred with Kevin. I know how hard it is to get a read on what he's doing because he moves so explosively. I mean, he threw a punch, he missed the punch, and it almost knocked me down. He didn't even hit me. It's incredible the speed at which he throws attacks.
Spinning heel kick there from Martin Nguyen. Drifts back to center ring, does a little shuffle. Pops out the jab, does Belingon. Final 10 seconds of the round. An intriguing contest. It's edge of the seat stuff here in Manila. Side kick negates the overhand right, and there we go to the tag.
It's interesting how Martin, he anticipates the bound. Break like that. You know, he kind of acknowledges that and he leads the way with that. Here it is. Look at the shuffle. Boom. Left hand landed by Kevin. Beautiful left hand as Martin was trying to adjust stances right there. You can see just how Kevin drops his head to protect from that right hand as he's swinging wildly. Interesting second round.
And this is the man that the winner will most likely meet later this year. Viviano Fernandez, the bantamweight world champion, sidelined with a foot injury. Says he'll be competitive again by October.
Look at Nguyen, not on the stool.
Nguyen may be sending a mental message to Kevin Belingon, not taking a seat between rounds. A sellout crowd here in Manila. It's the hottest ticket in town. It's one championship.
An interesting second round. Both the first and second rounds were very close.
Both men throwing the heavy leather early on. Nguyen fakes a takedown, throws that punt kick.
I like how he did that. He was possibly looking for an overhand to come up with that left hook, but he chose to throw the kick instead.
Fakes a front kick to Belingon. Nguyen goes to the midsection, goes to the high inside thigh.
Look how Martin's mixing up the weapons. Inside leg kick, front push kick.
Belingon needs to try and close down the movement of Nguyen. Step across inside thigh kick. Nguyen goes up to the rib cage. Fake slow again, does Nguyen.
Both these guys look like they're prepared to go the full 25 minutes. They look just as fresh now as they did in the first couple minutes of the first round.
There has never been a question mark surrounding the fuel tank of any man from Team Lakai at the altitude they train at.
Man, you get up there and you start training and your lungs start to close up on you. It's a very interesting phenomenon to train at elevation like that if you're not used to it. And when these guys are raised in elevation, they don't just go there and train, they were born at that height.
We're talking about Baguio City and the Philippines, the home of Team Lakai, that boasts the likes of Kevin Belingon, Edward Falayan, Danny Kingan, Jay Hayustakrio, and more. A little bit of a shuffle again here from Nguyen. Want to start to see both of these men committing a lot more here. And Belingon tries to. Look at the foot there from Kevin Belingon. Goes to the body now to the Filipino.
He's had a lot of success inside the close, dirty boxing type exchanges, especially when Nguyen's starting to back up.
Remember, Nguyen said he did not want it to go to the judges tonight. Has in his last two contests against Bibiano Fernandez and against Christian Lee. Lost in his bantamweight title bid to Bibiano Fernandez. Razor-thin decision to the Brazilian. High kick there from Belingon.
Like how Nguyen came up with an uppercut off that failed takedown attempt. He's starting to mix things up a little bit, the shootbox type style.
Just an adjustment of his trunks there for Belingon. 2 minutes 20 remaining, third round of five. And our main event, Belingon. referee Olivia Coles checks it out, gives the AOK to continue.
We had doctors on hand, but we don't have any tailors to fix situations like that.
It's Manila. There's a lot here. They make great suits, Mitch. Sure we can find one in a hurry. Left hook there from Belingon. Martin Nguyen. You want to see a little more pepper here from Nguyen.
When you're the champion, you're the most hunted man in the entire organization, especially when you hold titles in multiple divisions. So there's a lot of tape on Martin. People are constantly studying him. You know, from what people know what Martin wants to do. So there's a lot of people that are fine-tuning their strategies when it comes to, you know, Martin Nguyen. And that's what Team Lakai is best at. So it's not like Martin's not trying to be exciting, not trying to be explosive, but his opponents are just coming more.
And the high kick from Belingon. Yes, sense that the ticking time bomb may be ready to explode. Belingon launching the heavy artillery. 1:10 remaining in the third. Martin Nguyen staying patient. A cerebral culture.
That uppercut as Martin Nguyen started to close that distance, and now he's putting punches together.
Martin Nguyen double jab.
This is what Kevin wants. He wants to get comfortable and throw those shots. This is what he does best. Martin Nguyen has so many weapons. He needs to utilize the wrestling. Back Kevin up against the cage, force a takedown. Some scrambling, drain on Kevin a little bit.
We've seen Kevin unleash some power. Celebrators, have any of them affected the two-division champion, though, Mitch?
Doesn't look like it. Kevin's hit Martin with some big shots, and Martin's really not fazed by it. That front push kick, or that kind of that whipping front kick that he's throwing, is very effective. It's cutting through the guard of Belingon, and it's landing. It's not doing a lot of damage, but it's scoring.
The thing about Martin Nguyen, he's constantly on the move. He's never a stagnant target. Completely different to the last five opponents. But Belingon has competed him and beat him. And Belingon having trouble tonight, closing down the movement of Martin Nguyen. He'll get a chance to recover from the accidental groin shot here.
The most devastating right hand in all of ONE Championship just went a little bit low right there. So that's gotta hurt. Usually puts people to sleep.
Seconds left on the clock, so as soon as they recommence, it will be over this round. But Belingon is allowed 5 minutes for recovery and medical examination.
Now we're getting into the fourth round, and this is typically where we see Martin Nguyen really start to do his best work.
I wonder if they shouldn't get those shorts replaced between rounds for Kevin Belingon. They may be annoying him, but also the risk of maybe one of Martin's feet, if he kicks him, getting caught in the trunks. There are 2 seconds left in the round, but Belingon is allowed 5 minutes for recovery. If he is unable to continue, an official decision will be given. That is the end of the round, and we go to the towns. Okay, Mitch Chilson, let's play coach here for a moment. If you're in the corner of the two-division champion, Martin Nguyen, what are you telling Martin to do?
Well, let's see what he was doing here in the third round. Boom, landing the overhand right. You know, he's trying to mix up these weapons. I'd like to see him, you know, fake the overhand right and then set up that takedown. Throw the overhand, see how Kevin reacts. Throw the overhand again, but then go in for the takedown. Try to put Kevin on his back. Take him out of this realm, because Kevin is kind of falling into his rhythm and he's landing some big strikes. What do I think Kevin should do? Kevin needs to push the action a little bit. He needs to try to shut down the movement, back Martin up against the cage and let go of some of these big strikes, utilizing that jab and also that leg kick. I'd like to see Kevin start kicking the legs of Martin again to start slowing down some of that movement.
What a night it's been so far here in Manila. Great to see Henzo Gracie flying. And ONE Championship trending on Twitter here in the Philippines. They touch gloves. this, the penultimate round, 4 of 5. Muin fakes and fakes. He drifts off to his right, staying away from the power hand of Belingon. Thrust out the jab, does the Aussie. Belingon fakes. We're in deep water now. Muin with an outside thigh kick. Belingon tried to counter with those heavy hands.
Martin's movement is exceptional. He's evading the counter strikes of Belingon very well, consistently moving his forward. But if Belingon starts to close the distance a little bit more, he might be able to connect on some of these shots.
Oh, pump kick there, and a counter left hook from Belingon. Throws the right down the center corridor. And Martin Nguyen, a little too slick, a little too evasive. Belingon's got to find a way to close down the angles of Martin Nguyen. Nguyen fakes the right hand. Nguyen can be so frustrating to take on. The distance, the angles, the timing, the evasion of the two division champion. Is the distance a problem for Belingon tonight, Mitch?
I think it's the distance and it's also the reach. You can't quite reach Martin.
He reached him. Center cage. Fires out the left hook again. Now Nguyen takes center cage. Belingon fakes the jab. Nguyen shoots in, and Belingon stuffs the takedown attack.
Interesting. That takedown defense, that's actually like the seventh or eighth time Kevin has stopped the takedown of Martin Nguyen. And that's going to score as well. Kevin is able to control and dictate where this match is taking place.
There's the overhand right from Nguyen. There's the jab from the Australian. Belingon looking to edge the distance. Closing on Nguyen. With those hands, he swings to the body and Nguyen gets out of dodge.
Kevin might need to start taking a little bit more risks, start pushing forward with this action, because I don't know how the judges, how are they gonna see this? Are they gonna see the striking superiority and the movement of Martin Nguyen? Are they gonna see the aggression of Kevin Belingon?
Nguyen goes to the outside thigh. 1:45 remains of the 4th of 5 rounds. Wicked left hook from Belingon. Hasn't found the target cleanly though.
It's just the reach, his arms are just not long enough to touch Nguyen. Throwing a lot of shots, but they're just not anywhere close to Martin.
Belingon sets the right hand here. Front kick there from Nguyen. Nguyen's so quick twitch, the way he moves around, snaps out the jab. Fake again from Nguyen. Belingon wants to set a power silver. Muin Gafurov kicks the ribs of the Australian. Under a minute remaining in this round. This crowd wants Belingon to pull the trigger. They want him to unload. They're all on the edge of their seats inside the massive mall of Asia Arena. There's the right hand from Martin Nguyen. Just get a feeling the hairs on the back of your neck. At some stage, Belingon's gonna pull out all the stops. Belingon's gonna go hell for leather. Final seconds. As Mitch said, it could take one big shot to swing the pendulum and to turn the tide. And it looks like we're going to have to wait to the 5th and final round to find it.
There's There's still like 10 seconds left as we're walking away.
So
that frustration?
Remaining.
Is that gamesmanship? What do you think that is?
Nguyen looking very nervous, playing with the rings here, cage side. The kids are back home in Sydney with her mum. She's a part of the sellout crowd inside the Mall of Asia Arena.
Let's take a look at some of the past action here. Kevin Belingon goes airborne right now as he goes headhunting to entertain the crowd. But then Martin was able to answer back with a beautiful left hook, and then he came right up underneath. I think this is where he sets up the uppercut, but we just missed it. Nice shots overall by both opponents. Michael, tough call. How do you see the first four rounds?
You want to leave it to the judges or
this
what?
One is close, Mitch. It is still anyone's bout for the taking. We are 5 minutes away from finding out who will become the interim bantamweight world champion. This crowd rallying behind Kevin Belingon. Nguyen expected it. Belingon said he'd knock out the Australian.
It's gonna come down to who can throw caution to the wind, find that next level, and really start pushing the action.
Overhand right from Belingon. Jab from Nguyen. Both men still look fresh as a daisy. Inside thigh kick from Belingon. Jab from the Australian. Drops level, almost takes a knee to the face from Belingon. That was nice timing for the Philippine.
It was, he's timing it correctly. It's like a striking chess match. I mean, everybody, I mean, they're trying to take risks. They're trying to... tries to back him up against the cage.
Nguyen trying to close down the movement. Shoots it again. Good defense once more from Kevin Belingon. The rangefinder from the Filipino. Overhand right from Martin Nguyen. Left hook from the Aussie. Goes to the body. Goes to the brick basket. There's the overhand right from Nguyen. He came agonizingly close. Nguyen shouting, go Martin in the background. A high right roundhouse from Belingon. There's the jab. Overhand right from Belingon. Went higher than Michael Ostrom.
That sidestep, man, is beautifully done. Martin's got great movement in his eyes. That's what makes him so dangerous, is his constant movement. He sees things coming and just slides out of the way.
Nguyen jamming, Nguyen faking, Belingon goes to the body. We've got over 2 minutes remaining. Who will become the interim bantamweight world champion? Jab from Nguyen, jabbing well. Martin Nguyen, more jab for the pin cushion. Here in the final round, and Belingon to the inside thigh. Goes down to the body now, off the lead hand. 90 seconds on the clock.
Good defense by Belingon. I'm seeing the aggression shown by Nguyen. He's the one pushing forward. He's evading a lot of shots.
Martin Nguyen hunting for the overhand right. There it goes again. Hoping for the headache maker. Both men swing wildly. They have power cross elbows. They are designed to knock you out. If only they could connect. Uppercut there from Martin Nguyen. Nguyen shoots it for a double leg. And once more, Belingon defends the takedown. Jab from Belingon. This is the best round of the match so far. Now they're pulling out all the stops. Now they're throwing caution to the wind in Manila. Side kick from Belingon. Nguyen looks to cut off the count. 30 seconds to go. There's the CEO and founder of One Championship, Chatri Sitjatong, to present the gold. Let's go to Dominic Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, after five rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision.
Their corners for the opening round. Leg kicks early. And a man from Paranagua in Brazil, John Lineker. Gafurov, five match win streak dating back to November 2016, all first round finishes. Lineker, eight first round finishes, the fastest being a 78 second knockout of Luis Neves back in 2011. 3-2 in his last five, 8-2 in his last 10, Lineker. Including wins over Rob Font, Brian Kelleher, and John Dodson.
Muin Gafurov's content to stand on the feet with John Lineker. He says that he wants to test his stand-up against some of the very best in the world, and he believes he can do that. Even though John Lineker drops people faster than Bitcoin, Muin Gafurov has no fear to stand there and bang.
Gafurov began his pro career with nine consecutive first-round finishes between 2013 and 2016. Just a tentative start here. Overhand right from hands of Stone Lineker. High kick from Gafurov. Out of southpaw starts. Now orthodox starts.
Gafurov's thrown a lot of kicks just to understand the range. He's been able to do that. Lineker's only thrown hands so far.
We asked Gafurov a couple of days ago why the inactivity. He said, well, no one wants to get in the circle against me. They're all scared of me. Not hands of Stone.
Short-range punches are where Lineker's most dangerous, though, when he catches you walking into him with those short little hooks and uppercuts.
Combat Sambo world champion two times, Muin Gafurov, one of over 140 martial arts world champions we have here at One Championship. Seven subs. And Lineker's last submission win, you've got to go back to 2015 against Francisco Rivera in the first round by a guillotine choke. Gafurov comes forward. Yeah. Lineker, the former bantamweight champion of jungle fights, went 4-0 with that promotion. Open for UFC 2-0 judo Brazil for John Lineker. Outside leg kick, Lineker counters here from Gafurov. The crowd inside the Soldado Estora Center Yard on the edge of their seats for this one. Inside a third boot! How about that? The speed of Lineker! The spinning hook kick from Gafurov!
And these guys are going at it. Nice little sprawl there from John Lineker. When these guys start to let their hands go, you can hear a hush all over the crowd.
Almost oh, connected to the right hook. There's Lineker. He caught him with a chin. Tried to shake the beard. Now the Muay Thai kick from the high knee. The body shot from Lineker. Gafurov backs off. Under 2 minutes remaining. A great first round.
That might have hurt him. Gafurov looks a little bit wobbled. He's got to slow things down a little bit. Lineker's trying to turn on.
Hands of stone indeed.
Slow this down, start kicking the legs. As they say, that Lineker kicks the legs.
Lineker has the number of Muin Gafurov so far in the opening round. Counter right hand from Hands of Stone.
Head movement from Lineker. Look at him cutting the angles. Trying to trap Muin Gafurov up against the circle wall.
The Brazilian is open for business on his one championship debut. Looks to cut off the circle here. Gafurov still regaining his composure.
That's what he's able to do here. He's circling around and Lineker's giving him the opportunity to. He gives the stop to him for the right moment.
The push from Lineker. Four hooks for the Pirates convention from the Brazilian. Breaks the overhand right. Gafurov takes the outside fire kick. Wild hands again from Lineker. Tries to pull the head down for the high knee. Outside leg kick from Lineker. You feel that Gafurov just wants to see out the first round. Go back to his corner, take a rest, get the instructions, reset for the second.
He had a better first half of the round. He was able to utilize the range, utilize the kicks. But then once Lineker started to jump on him, he changed his mind real quick, started shooting for takedowns.
Is he good?
A great opening round for John Lineker of Brazil.
That right hand of John Lineker will make you rethink your life choices. You change your mind real fast. A lot of back and forth action in this, but then look at how Lineker was just landing those leg kicks, upended Muin Gafurov. I think that was the first combination there. There's Muin Gafurov rethinking things, going for the takedown. But that dirty boxing range where Lineker's grabbing the head and then they just start swinging at each other. There's Muin Gafurov thinking about the takedown again. Nice combinations landed by Lineker as he goes to the body, then back up to the chin. This is where Muin Gafurov was in trouble. But I like how Lineker, this 40-match veteran at the young age of just 29, kept his composure, didn't freak out, stayed nice and tight and controlled. Muin Gafurov pops up off the stool, ready to get started in the sixth minute.
Muin Gafurov needs to clip the wings of John Lineker early here in the second round.
Ready?
Gafurov, who grew up a keen footballer before his uncle introduced him to combat sambo when he was 14. His uncle, also the president of the Tajikistan Sambo Federation, was actually raised by his four uncles, Gafurov. Four of the martial artists after Gafurov's father was murdered. Drives him against the wall here, there's Muin Gafurov. Lineker trying for the choke.
Good change of game plan by Muin Gafurov to mix things up. Catches the leg kick, shoots in for the double. Looks like Lineker's going for a squeeze here.
And Lineker got his first submission since 2015. There was a guillotine back then. Is it going to be another one now?
Lineker's got a good squeeze here. Might be tight. You can see Muin Gafurov's trying to pop that leg out so he can circle to the side. More of a neck crank. Let's go.
Lineker can't get career shot number 5. And that's top position for Muin Gafurov. The ground and pound back for the combat sambo two-time world champion. After position.
Good pressure shown by Gafurov to keep him up against the circle wall. Let's see if he can slide the hips out and drag him away, because Lineker's going to try to use that wall to work his way back up.
Lineker, who made his pro debut in 2008, amazingly competed 11 times in his first 15 months.
Stand up from Lineker. He's overhooked and dragged back down to the ground by Gafurov. As soon as he went for that overhook, Muin changed levels and dragged him right back down to the canvas.
Don't forget, Muin Gafurov does have a 100% finishing rate. In 15 wins, 7 submissions, 8 knockouts. He does not win by decision. Lineker, 14 knockouts, 4 subs in 31 wins, a 58% finishing rate. Now Gafurov trying his own guillotine attempt. How about that? Lineker just throws him to the canvas like yesterday's garbage.
Get off of me, says Lineker. I like how he uses the wall so effectively to get back up. The work of a veteran right there.
Uppercut from Gafurov, looking at backup hands of stone. Fires out a right cross, out of orthodox stance. Did switch a little in the opening round, Muin Gafurov. Lineker drifting into the power side of Gafurov. Turning back kick, hoping to connect with the heel to the liver.
That's a good little combination. Through the right hand, got him moving to the left, tried to change it up, spinning back, kick. Lineker saw the takedown coming, slides out the way.
Under 2 minutes remaining, John turning back into the liver again there. Trying to impact that vagus nerve and close down the entire body. Liver shot said to be the most painful way you can get knocked out in combat sports. Jab from Lineker, no right hand for company. Gafurov. Lineker cannot afford to window shop here. Not afford to let Gafurov establish any sort of momentum.
Lineker again gets pressed up against the circle wall. Good defense there as he defended again. Another takedown.
Spinning hook kick from Gafurov. More kick than a chorus line for Gafurov here in the second.
Gafurov's had a much better second round. His use of distance, his timing, a lot more effective. He switches stances.
Makes an inside kick as he went to southpaw here and stays in southpaw, Gafurov. High kick off the left leg now, back to orthodox, that's his preferred stance. Throws the right hand lead, followed by a lead hook. Lineker has fallen off the pace here, Dragon.
He's slowing down. I mean, when you put everything you've got into every single punch you're throwing, it's going to affect your gas tank. And now Muin Gafurov was able to pace himself in the first, at least recover from the first, and now he's showing signs that he's starting to take advantage here in the second. He's taking some of Lineker's best shots, and he's eating them, and he's still standing, so it's got to give him a lot of confidence, especially as we enter the third round here.
I don't know if Lineker was expecting the spinning back kicks from Muin Gafurov. Gafurov goes from a double to a single leg. Can he sit down the Brazilian?
Lineker's smart. He's not circling to the power side of Muin Gafurov. He's circling to the left. Or he's circling to his right, Muin's left. And what that does is it puts him into perfect position for those spinning kicks. Here's the guillotine by Gafurov as he jumps guard to go to the guillotine, but Muin does a beautiful job to avoid the full guard of Lineker. Here's Gafurov going for his own guillotine. Lineker's like, get off me, they got nothing on me. Again, Gafurov shoots in. Beautiful, look at this. Sees this hook kick coming, charges in, defends beautifully. We're seeing a very multi-dimensional game from Muin Gafurov. He's mixing things up very well. The takedown attempts, with the kicks, with the punches. We're seeing just the punches and the leg kicks coming from Lineker. This third round, it's pretty close right now. I think it could go either way. Whoever's got the most gas left in the tank in these final five might walk away with that one championship medal.
Don't forget, folks, follow us across all your socials.
ready?
Social media platforms at ONE Championship on YouTube, Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook. Play the ONE Fantasy game, the world's largest martial arts fantasy game, now available on the ONE Super app. For this one, 65% of fans took the win for John Lineker, 35 for Muin Gafurov.
I love that show of respect right there. He give you a hug and try to punch you in the face.
High kick, double forearms guard by Lineker. We saw the kicks really come into play in the Arsenal level. Gafurov in the second round. Lineker slowed down in the second. He was the better in the first. This is not scored round by round, however. We are scoring as an overall contest. Three judges circle side. Wherever you're watching, in over 140 countries around the world, hope you're enjoying it live from Jakarta, Indonesia. Turning back kick, hoping to find the liver again there from Muin Gafurov. And Lineker closed down the lateral movement of Gafurov. Overhand right to a left hook there from Lineker, nothing connecting for the Brazilian. Gafurov hoping for a takedown, hoping again, good score there from Lineker.
Felt that leg kick, Lineker threw all the way over here. He seems to start to beat up that lower leg. Gafurov's tough, man, he's not showing that it's hurting too much. Trade right hands there, or left hands.
Third round for Gafurov is very unfamiliar territory. He's only been here twice before. And he's been here twice before, he's lost on both occasions. As mentioned earlier, to Kevin Belingon and to Reese McLaren. Spinning hook kick there from Gafurov. Are those hook kicks going to pay dividends for Gafurov, Mitch, or should he leave them at home and concentrate on something else?
You know, a lot of times it's just sort of a reaction that they throw, you know, especially when they grow up kind of throwing those kicks. Once they see the opening, they spin like the Lakai guys, like our co-main eventer, Nicky Holskin. They just react. It's just something that they do. But Lineker's kind of got it, and he's got the distance down. You can see how he's constantly pushing forward. If he was at the end of the range, he'd have a lot more success with him. Because Lineker's constantly pushing forward, he's only kind of catching him with the calf that hook kick.
Lead hand there from Gafurov, drifts off to his left now, tries to stifle the movement with the right hand as Lineker. Overhand right from Gafurov, Lineker counter hook, couldn't connect for the Brazilian. Jow to overhand right from Lineker, good combination work. Outside leg kick, and a beautiful takedown from Muin Gafurov.
Beautiful double leg at 2 minutes to go. In a very closely contested match. God, oh man, how do you know who's winning right now? The judges got such a tough time scoring this one.
Knees on the inside from Muin Gafurov, and referee Olivier Cole says one hit the groin. Gafurov protesting. Wait, wait. There will be injury recovery time here for John Lineker. As you said, Mitch, such a razor close contest. I'd hate to be a judge on this one. And with a couple of minutes remaining, it may be a matter of who can go kleptomaniac and steal this match. Who will really put the foot down, land some telling blows, maybe get a takedown with a follow through. Let's see what happens.
Who's got the big elbow left?
All right, time.
I think it's okay to go on.
Ready? Two.
Right hand there from Gafurov, overhand right Lineker. Big arms on John Lineker. Edges forward. Jumping punt kick there, can't call it a front kick from Muin Gafurov. Shuffles into the power side of Lineker. And drifts to his left as he does now. He goes into the right side of Lineker, which is where Hands of Stone comes from. Probing with the lead hand. Will Gafurov go for a spinning technique again here?
You can see when he widens his stance up, that's usually what he's thinking.
Shifts the weight, spins around, doesn't throw the kick. Looks for a double leg, Lineker defends. Gafurov still wants to try and take the Brazilian down.
Tenacity.
Tenacious takedown so far right now from Muin Gafurov. Let's see if he can suck the single leg in, turn the corner, and put Lineker down. But Lineker's got good defense up against the circle wall. His best chance to take him down is usually out in the open. But up against the wall, Lineker knows what he's doing up against that wall.
Now, most people thought this one wouldn't go the distance with 33 finishes between them, but we're only 30 seconds away now from going down to the judges. How are you scoring it, folks? Let us know on Twitter, @1Championship. Do you have it for Gafurov? Do you have it for Lineker? Lineker on his one championship debut. Final 10 seconds. Heel kick there.
See, that time he was at the end of the range. He wasn't standing, he wasn't consistently pushing forward. So it was excellent timing on that spinning back kick.
Great respect for both of these warriors. And only one will emerge triumphant. Will the winner's medal go back to Brazil? Or will it go to Touch and Start? Man. Sold out inside the Estora Senayan in Jakarta for one championship, Dawn of Valor.
Man, you see that first 5 minutes, you have to give it to John Lineker. The second was pretty close, but then in the third round, you started to see things sort of even out. You got to ask yourself, who did the most damage in this matchup? Was it the possible leg kicks landed by Lineker early? Was it the hook kicks? Was it the punches landed by Lineker? It's a tough call to say. You know, the takedowns also scored for Muin Gafurov. It was a very closely contested matchup the entire way through.
Scored, folks. The man left of screen, Lineker. The man right of screen, Gafurov. Gafurov has never won by decision. It'll be a first for him. Let's go to Tom Lau and find out our winner.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner. By unanimous decision from the red corner, John Lineker.
Michael Chiavello, Mitch Chilson with you. Belingon in the red, Fernandez in the black. It may very well be the raw power of Belingon, the finesse and technique of Bibiano Fernandez.
You see Kevin throwing that lead hook. That's how he sets up that spinning kick. He's looking for the spin early. Bibiano testing the leg right there.
We saw the turning back kick to the liver of Andrew Leone. One of the most spectacular kicks we've ever seen. It sent Leone a full 10 feet across the ring on that night. Was the beginning of the end for Leone. And there it is from Belingon, turning back it to the liver.
That's one to the body already.
Jab from Belingon, outside fly kick from Bibiano, looking to drop down for a single leg there, the Brazilian. Belingon saying he received a groin strike, and a moment's break here called by referee Olivier Cox. Certainly the aggressive start, though, from Kevin Belingon here, Mitch. He's turning early. He's trying to line up the power salvo.
That's what he said. He wanted to attack the body. This is the exchange. Bibiano went low right there as he was attempting an inside leg kick. Yes, he went back up. A flurry of punches. He was looking for the takedown. The takedown wasn't there. It came over the top, but he did tap the groin.
Just a caution there from our referee Olivia Ghost. Accidental groin strike, of course, but you hit the groin and the pain receptors kick in. So a moment to recover here for Kevin Belingon, who's already showing his hand very early on in this world title match. We can see the game plan here of Kevin, as you said, to go to the body of Bibiano Fernandez. They believe that's the weakness. They believe that's the chink in the armor of Bibiano Fernandez.
This is how he likes to set up, right there to the low, right there. No denying that it happened. You can almost hear the crack going right there. But Bibiano shakes it off, being the pro that he is, ready to put in work.
They recommence here in the first round of action. Look for the body work again from Belingon, the man with the flowing mullet. Fernandez, the bantamweight champion, the greatest champion in ONE history. Never beaten here in ONE. He
Nguyen's got that reach advantage. I'd seen throughout that jab. Start testing the distance.
Oh, he just put BB on the jaw with that short left hand. BB dropping low levels to try and lock onto a leg to take down Belingon. Belingon does not want to go to the ground with Fernandez. Fernandez, double leg here, trying to get the Filipino down. Belingon not going there, however. Body shot from Belingon.
This will be a good first test for Kevin Belingon's takedown defense. He looked stellar against Martin Nguyen in the takedown defense, but Bignano is a different breed of grappler. Look at him attacking the legs. Look at Kevin. Good defense so far. He's got to be careful. That's where you want to go.
Inside of half guard here. Fence, Bibi fence, Fernandez, fence. Top position, peppering palm strikes to the side of the head of Kevin Belingon. Now Belingon finds himself in Bibi land. How do they defend against the several submission attempts and the ground and pound that Bibi can bring from these positions?
First thing he needs to do is take that right arm and start looking for an underhook. In half guard position, if he can get an underhook underneath the left arm of Bibiano, he's going to be able to turn onto his side. Now he's got the arms trapped on the other side, so he's got the half guard on the other side. That's what he needs to start doing. He needs to get one side on the underhook, because right now he's got his half guard on the left leg of Bibiano and the underhook on the other side, the right side of Bibiano. So he's kind of trapped himself in this position. Bibiano can apply pressure with his shoulder and look to pass the guard.
Watch out,
to create
watch
movement
out.
In this space. He doesn't want to give Bibiano the opportunity
on,
to start setting things up.
Fernandez, a BJJ sensation, five-time world champion, three-time Pan-American champion, has won 11 gold medals in elite BJJ competitions around the world. It's been an aggressive start from
Bibi.
Don't run
the fence, guys. Don't run the
fence. He finish a three-point try and take Belingon into deep water. Fernandez has a proven gas tank. He's gone five rounds, five times in his career, winning all five times by decision.
No technique on the escape right there. Pure explosion to get out of the half guard there of Bibiano Fernandez.
Resets here. This Belingon has power in the legs.
Oh, a turning back kick to the liver. And there's one to the head. He tries to take his head off. The headache maker for Belingon. He's put the power early. And Fernandez looked a little shocked momentarily. Especially the spinning hook kick to the head. There's another turning back kick to the liver.
He was right. They are definitely going after the body with that spinning back kick. And look how fast he comes out of that. There's almost no setup. He's not even throwing that hook. It's just an explosion into that turning back kick.
The liver, a very large organ in the upper right portion of the abdomen, highly vascular area. A shot to the liver can be excruciatingly painful.
30 seconds left in the first round.
Martial articles say the most painful way to get knocked out is with a liver shot. Turning back into the liver again there from Belingon. It's about the size of a football, the liver, right side of the body. Mostly protected by the rib cage, but still slightly exposed. And if you dig in between the 9th and 10th rib, you hit that vagus nerve, it can close down the entire body. That's what Belingon's looking to do with his turning back kick. There's one from Bibi Fernandez. But my word, what a start here from Kevin Belingon. He went straight to the game plan. He showed his hand. There's the new VP, Misha Tate. There's Mighty Mouse, Demetrius Johnson. So many luminaries here at Cape Side in Singapore for one championship.
This is what they're watching. That was spinning back kick landed, not close to the liver, but up top a little bit. That one was hunting again after it. He is repeatedly going after that. But that up top kick was a beautiful spinning heel kick. Caught Bibiano high on the guard, veteran that he is, caught that kick.
Okay, Mitch, play coach for a moment. If your team look high, what are you telling Kevin Belingon to do?
Kevin Belingon is putting things together beautifully right now. Their game plan is working to the T. I'd like to see Kevin Belingon set that up a little bit, throw the jab, get him thinking about the hands first, get Bibiano to lift his hands up, then spin the attack to the body. Bibiano, he's got to move forward. He's a little bit tentative there in the last couple, about 90 seconds of that first round. He started to slow down a bit. He was watching careful to the body.
Ready?
Likes to Bibiano throw the hands and start to chain wrestle with him. Back Kevin up against the cage and take him down and grind on him.
Singapore has been a happy hunting ground for Bibiano Fernandez. It was here in 2013 that he won the title. Well, to unify the one bantamweight world title, by betting Sutil Kim. Oh, good right hand, stiffly there from Belingon. Bibi tries to thread the right hook, turning back into the liver. Bibi backs it up with the right hand. Double leg now from the Brazilian. Gets the takedown, and we're back in Bibi land. The half guard position. Let's see what Fernandez can do. The takedown has come early in the second round.
And we were set up with the hands. He was able to utilize the boxing, back Kevin up with the big right hand, get him up against the cage, and now he's grinding on him. Now Bibiano's going to start to slowly and methodically work on Kevin. He's got to slow him down a little bit. He's got to get Kevin to expend some energy. Kevin is extremely explosive. That's how he got out of the first exchange here on the ground. He was able to just throw Bibi off on him.
Let's go, guys.
The explosion, the fast twitch muscle fiber of Kevin Belingon is at an all-time high. Bibiano needs to slow him down.
It's going to serve well mentally for Kevin Belingon that he's out of the first round. Last time they met in 2016, Bibiano tapped out Belingon with a Kimura in just 4 minutes and 4 seconds. Here he is in the second round, and Belingon told us, I'm a completely different martial arts machine than I was last time we fought.
Every single one of Team Nakai always excels in the rematch. They go back, they've got their head coach who breaks everything down, and they always find a way to be much more successful in the second time
fence,
around.
Fence, fence.
When they run it back, Team Nakai, second team.
Now we're on 19-5, 11 finishes, including 8 knockouts, 9 of those in the very first round. Scramble here. Belingon back to his feet. Seems to be overwhelming Filipino support for Kevin Belingon in the crowd here in Singapore tonight.
And again, he exploded out of the technique.
And the chants go up for Kevin Belingon, the underdog here in Singapore. Bibi avenges it, tries to loop in the tag, and Belingon gets out of the way. What a matchup for the bantamweight championship of the world. It's one championship, Heart of the Lion, live from the Singapore Indoor Stadium. Got the right hand cocked and ready here, Belingon. Shifts off to his left. Bibi dead center of the cage. Jab there from Fernandez. Belingon taking his time. Very patient match so far from Belingon. Overhand right misses.
Everything Kevin throws is full force. There's no waiting out process, no setup. Everything is just one big shot trying to take that head off of Bibiano Fernandez. But good eyes from the veteran. He's moving out well. And so Kevin is extending.
He got airball on that! Jump turning back kick to the belly button of Bibiano Fernandez. He must have been half a foot off the ground, Mick. That was incredible.
You hear the crack from that side kick.
Take down there from Fernandez. Now the Brazilian up the intensity, up the aggression, takes the back of Belingon. Here's Bibiano. This is what Fernandez does so well. The body triangle locked on. And Belingon's got no place to go. Belingon could be in trouble here. Bibiano goes for the arm. Goes for the arm. Takes the arm. Can he find the finish?
Kevin Belingon pushed the leg off of Bibiano. A straight escape. Threw the arm off. Or threw the leg off, rather. Saved the arm. But Bibiano's still taking it.
He sent the arm off. This place going bananas! The ground and pound from Belingon!
Bibiano is covered up. A lot of this is coming off. Those landed right there, though. Bibiano's laughing. He's okay.
Have a look at Belingon. It's a
Vignano still attacking off his back, group an armbar attempt right there. Now he's got the high guard. Look for him to go for a triangle. He's got one arm trapped there on the side. He's going to let it go. He's still got the arm trapped. Looking for the arm bar. Survived the back. Look at baby. Look at the way he's trapped that right left arm. Throws the leg over. Look at Kevin. Get off me. Get that leg off me. He's okay. I'm okay. Get that leg off. Viviano covers back up. Still has that arm trapped. Look how he traps the arm with his leg. Hooks in like he's doing a hamstring curl. Completely has the arm trapped. Uses his right arm to attempt it again. Goes after it again. Kevin shrugs him off, gets on top, and drops the grounded pound. What a second round, Michael Schiavello.
Kevin Belingon, more escapes than Michael Schofield in that round. And what have we got in store for you in the third? It's an absolute barn burner. Belingon first to emerge from his stall.
Let's go.
Third round of five. We are heading towards that deep water. Bibiano's been there many times before, and this sellout crowd here in Singapore loving every moment of a truly epic main event. Let's see if Belingon goes back to that river with the turning Wushu back kick. Belingon begins martial arts career in Wushu. Was awarded a Wushu scholarship to the University of Encordilleras. Led to his move to Baguio City, and then of course joined the great team Lagai. Here's a Philippines national Wushu champion. And we've been seeing some of that Wushu striking. Belingon just falling short with that right hand. Overhand right there.
Let's go, Kevin.
There's the turning back into the midsection, trying to put the belly button through the back. Bibi measuring with the jab, resets now. Good right hand lead there from Fernandez.
The reach of Bibiano is, that's what makes him so effective on the stand-up. He just utilizes that reach so very well. You can see Kevin throws big, wide, looping shots. You can see how his elbows are nice and flared. That leaves a hole right through the middle. Bibiano's trying to exemplify, he's trying to exploit it, but Kevin is throwing everything with still 100% power.
Training partner, Mighty Mouse Demetrius Johnson here, cage side. Bibiano Fernandez going for title defense number 10. Mighty Mouse has had 11 of them. Two amazing, complete martial arts warriors. Bibiano Fernandez finding himself right now in the match of his life. The crowd in Singapore against him. Kevin Belingon has brought the heat from the opening bell, but we saw the flash of Bibiano, the flash of the flash Fernandez in the second round when he came agonizingly close to taking home Kevin's arm.
And very close, but Kevin came just as close to going with the body. Those shots are going to start to pay dividends later in the match. Going to start to wear down Bibiano. Bibiano is not as fast as slow, but he's still landing with these shots.
Exquisite jab two from Bibiano, left hook there from Belingon. 2 minutes 40 remains, third round of five. The Philippines versus Brazil. Oh, almost caught him with the counter right hand there. And a snappy jab from Belingon. But Bibiano had the right idea. When Belingon commits that turning back into the liver, and he misses the target, the follow, the counter right hand could come smack bang on the kisser.
And where have we seen that before?
To Muin, give it to Edward Filayan.
Could be the answer to that little right there. Kevin showing his hand. He says, I'm going to spin. Bibiano has got to circle out to the side and land that hand over the right hand he's got.
Mitch, at any point here, do you feel that Belingon is going to the well one time too many, hunting after that turning back into the liver, that it may become predictable and BB may start to really time off it?
I mean, he's probably up near the double digits in attempting that spin kick. Bibiano's seen it, but he's got to avoid it. He can't take it over and over again. He's going to start to wear on him. And Kevin is throwing everything with full power. So you can see Kevin starting to slow down too. And this is his crowd. Interesting. Bibiano could have went into side control, but he chose to shove the legs between his legs, trap him, and slowly try to work his way into mount.
Let's go, guys, work!
A tremendous contest. Right in front of our Chinese commentary team across the country.
One minute left in the third round.
Of top position, Kevin Belingon. Hope you enjoy your post. Live in 138 countries, all live and free on the One Super app as Bibi Fernandez mounts Kevin Belingon.
And Belingon's got 45 seconds here. He's got to hold on tight to those arms, but now they're starting to be sweaty, so Bibiano slid the arm out. Now he's going to go. Look how he has that left arm there. He's nice and high. Kevin's got to pull him tight. It's a bad spot to be in, though. This sets up an armbar. Watch his knees. If he chooses to go high, oh, he goes flat. Applies the pressure there. Now he's. I think this is a ground and pound position right now.
20 seconds remains. Third round.
That's the veteran right there, Bibiano. He knows that they're slippery right now, so Kevin could pull out of an armbar. So he chose to go heavy hips and soften him up and end the round in a very dominant position.
Postures up now. Fernandez tries to drop the anvils on the head of Belingon. Snakes in the right hand. Three down, two to go.
That's a veteran move right there. He chose to not risk losing the position by going after the armbar. He flattened his hips out, softened Kevin up a little bit, went high right as the bell was about to ring, and just let the punches come down. And that, we don't go round by round. We go by the match in its entirety. But that is a great way to end 15 minutes right there, Mr. Shabello.
Star-studded team of God in the corner of Kevin Belingon. The landslide, Edward Goliath, who in a few weeks' time in Manila will take on Amir Khan for the World Lightweight Championship. There's Bibiano Fernandez. We know he's seen it all before.
Fast and hard.
Do you feel that Fernandez underestimated Belingon at all, Mitch?
No, I don't think so. I think he's seen the past six matches. I think he's seen the improvements that Kevin's made, but he's also extremely confident in himself, and he knows the type of martial artist that he is, the type of athlete that he is, and also the type of strategist that he is. Everything that he's doing is very methodical at this point. These are the championship rounds. This is where Bibiano lives and breathes.
Let's go, guys. Let's go.
The penultimate round. Jabbed in from Belingon. Jab from Bibiano Fernandez. Spinning heel kick from Belingon. Came close. Try to bring the heel to the temple. Cutting Wushu's side kick to the knee there. The common Belingon move just above the knee. Jab from Belingon to put down the points. Fernandez jab two, didn't have the strength behind it though.
And he's still landing on Kevin. And that's what's giving him a little bit of just success in the stand-up, is he still landing with these shots. And now what that's gonna do, it's gonna create an opening for him to just like that, throw that overhand right, change levels, and go after those legs.
Two absolute warriors who have overcome a lot of adversity early on in life. Fernandez almost dying from malaria, contracted in the Amazon jungle, where he was fending for himself and hunting and gathering as a seven-year-old. Belingon had to go through some loss of family members, raiding of bandits in his childhood home in the Philippines, abject poverty. And here here they are, both men in the main event at the top of the martial arts world. We've won championship here in Singapore.
Well, to finish.
Jumped over the half guard there, landed inside control. Kevin starts to look a little bit fatigued. This is not something we're used to seeing. That's that explosion that we're talking about. You can't explode out of like that. You have to make sure you're technical. You still got to maintain that technique, especially with a grappler like Bibiana Fernandez.
Once again, we are in the deep theater. As I said earlier, Fernandez, five times in his career, has gone the full five rounds, won all of those decisions.
Want to finish?
Doesn't look like Belingon's gas tank is slowing at all, even though he is the older statesman here. Side control for the Brazilian. 2 minutes 35 remaining, fourth of five, for the bantamweight championship of the world. Oh, elbow to the top of the head there from Belingon, trying to open up a cut perhaps. Cuts in the hip a little here from side control, does Fernandez. The media attention surrounding this main event all week here in Singapore. It's been extraordinary. So many photographers and reporters from newspaper, radio, television, websites. Some groundbreaking news released in one championship this week.
Let's go, one to finish.
And we are seeing a fitting main event. Looks for the full mouth as Fernandez slips out the back. He tries to take the arm. And once again, Belingon is free. And this crowd loves it. Another escape from Belingon.
Hard to finish an armbar this late in the match. They're so slippery, easy for them to pull out. But Bibiana, once he gets a hold of that arm, he's gonna stay tight with it. But Kevin is still so explosive, he's able to just power out of these shots, or these attempts at submissions.
125 on the clock now. Bibiano's gotten Belingon to deep water. You see that the aggressive striking, it's not fair as it was in the opening two rounds from Belingon. It's still dangerous as ever. It's a demoralizing niche that Bibi's trying to outmaster and securing them.
Not so much. I don't think he's demoralized. I think he's trying to figure out another solution. You could see him inside the side control, and he didn't want to give it up, but he's trying to finish. Bibiano is not the lay and pray. He's not going to stay there and just hold the position. He's going to try to finish you. He loves to finish his opponents, and he's always going to be looking for it. He made that as a calculated risk. It didn't pay off, but that's Bibiano Fernandez for you.
Fernandez controlling center. 30 seconds in the fourth round. Undefeated since 2010, Bibiano Fernandez. And what great rounds he's put along the way. Antonio Banuelos, Yoshiro Maeda, Koichiro Okazaki, Sutro Kim, Ueda, Daehwan Kim, Tony Taru, Chris McCullough. Oh, he gets it on the way! Belingon's third! And Bibi back to his feet. There's damage on the bridge of the nose of Bibi Fernandez. Another top thumping right hand into the round. We're going into the fifth and final. This is crazy!
That's the power of the silencer. Out of nowhere, the tide can change. He put Bibiano on his backside with that beautiful right hand. Look at Bibiano, measuring, calculating, right through the middle with the right hand. Watch Kevin Belingon using that power to slip his way out. The BJJ World Champion goes after the submission, has the armbar deep. Look at Kevin, no, not today. This is my moment to shine. Beautifully done. But what does Kevin still have? He still has that power in his right hand. The thunder in the right hand can be delivered at any moment. He's still dangerous. Still, even though he's tired, even though he's exhausted, he still has that one-hitter quitter, Michael.
Fifth and final round. 99% of pundits did not think it would get this far. But here we are, inside the sold-out Singapore Indoor Stadium for the Bantamweight Championship of the World. Who will prevail? They touch gloves. Outside leg kick from Fernandez, the champion.
outside leaking again. What tremendous heart. What aggression, what power from the interim champion, Kevin Belingon. Turning back kick to the liver from Belingon. All right, Mitch, with 4 minutes 30 remaining, what does Belingon need to do?
He's gonna have to land big. He's attacking that leg beautifully. See how Bibiano's limping a little bit on that leg? I think these things are starting to build up for him. But what's he doing? He's setting up that spinning back kick. He's gonna keep going to the well. He's gonna keep looking for that power. But what it's gonna do is it's gonna get Bibiano to drop his elbows down to his body to protect the body shot. What's that gonna do? That's gonna open up the head. Kevin Belingon can still come over the top with a beautiful right hand. Bibiano needs to work the jab. Needs to work the jab, set up that right hand, and look for the takedown. Put Kevin on his back and grind on him for the next 4 minutes. But he's got to get at least 2 minutes on the ground in a dominant position.
Time is ticking down. Fernandez sends a cut. Inside leg kick to the right hand. Good combination of Fernandez. Jab there from Belingon. Belingon looks for the outside lead leg. Can't find it. Lots of swelling around the brow of Kevin Belingon. Damage to the bridge of the nose of Bibiano Fernandez. High kick from Belingon. Fernandez saw that one coming. Jump turning back kick. Bon Jovi style. Shot to the heart. Bibi resets. Will one of these two men put their foot down and go for it? Throw caution to the wind. Howl for leather with 3 minutes remaining. Is it time to pull out all the stops? Leg kick there from Belingon and goes to the inside thigh.
Michael, at 20 minutes, I had Bibiano slightly ahead, even though he was knocked down by that right hand. But at this point, Kevin is starting to inch forward. He's starting to land these strikes. He's starting to outstrike Bibiano Fernandez. He's starting to connect more.
You wonder if with his experience, Bibiano may be trying to go kleptomaniac and steal them in the final minute or so. Jab from Belingon. This one's close. There's no doubt about it. It could turn any moment.
This is an extremely close match. I think it might come down to the last 2 minutes. Either way, right now Kevin's starting to find his rhythm. He's starting to land shots. Bibiano found his right home for that right hand just now.
Inside leg kick from Belingon, nice and high on that inside thigh.
There's a scoring, Michael. It's like the fifth one that's landed this round.
Belingon has been putting down the score with the striking here in the fifth. Bibi's got to change it up now. Got to go for something, either the strikes or look for that takedown. Jabs from both men.
I think he needs a takedown. He doesn't want to stand here with Kevin lighting him up. That's what he goes after. Oh, Kevin gets away from Bibiano Fernandez. Can he do that for another 90 seconds to keep on his feet? Keep going after that little inside leg kick.
Raised chickens. Looked like a greased chicken as he escaped Bibiano Fernandez moments ago. Chance went up to Bellingham. Big outside fight here from Fernandez. There's 1 minute 10 remaining for the Bantamweight Championship of the World. Making again from Bellingham. No doubt he's won the striking in this final round. Jab to Bibiano. What does Fernandez have left? He tries to catch him, but it's not catching Chris Lightning.
He's got to set that up better. He's got to throw those hands. He's got to get Kevin lifting up his hands to protect the head and then shoot him for the takedown. Nice leg kick.
Capture off a leg kick with the right hand from Belingon. Threads the jab, does Bibiano Fernandez. Under 40 seconds now. Leg kicks again from Belingon.
30 seconds left.
This is Belingon's world, man.
And the target prep for Belingon. On the back foot and out striking Fernandez. Fernandez has come forward. Belingon misses with another kick. 15 seconds now. Is there one big salvo left? Is there a Hail Mary shot? Final 10 seconds. This place going crazy. Belingon puts a fist in the air. He believes he's won it.
Championship.
what back and forth action. Every round was razor close. So many different variables go into judging this matchup. The striking superiority of Kevin Belingon, the shots landed by Bibiano Fernandez, the top control, the submission attempts. What an amazing unification bout between two world-class martial artists, two bantamweight world champions. Who is gonna leave Singapore with the strap? Michael Cervello.
Chatri Sinjitong, the founder of ONE Championship, to present the belt to the winner. Will it be Kevin Belingon? Will it be Bibiano Fernandez? Wherever you're watching live in 138 countries, live and free on the ONE Super app, how do you score it? Does Belingon claim his 20th career victory? Does Fernandez get his 23rd? Does Belingon stop the streak of Fernandez, the winning streak that dates back to 2011? Here we go.
Ladies and gentlemen, after five rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. Judge number one calls this bout in favor of the red corner. Judge number two scores this bout in favor of the blue corner. And judge number three calls this bout in favor of your winner by split decision. And now, the undisputed ONE Bantamweight Champion of the World,